not for the long run. See, the white supremacists, if they're really running things, what they'll do, there's a reason for people having a strike. And it could be that they want better working conditions, or they want more money, or a combination of both.
Yes, sir.
But what the white supremacists will do, sometimes they'll say, okay, I'll give you more money, and I'll give you better working conditions, but I'll also cut the number of people who are working. I'll double the salary of those who are working and cut the workforce in half.
Mm-hmm.
That way they come out doing the same thing anyway. Not only that, they come out ahead because now they're going to triple the workload of the people who are working.
So,
white supremacists always run the whole show in any business that has to do with non-white people anywhere in the world, in any area of activity. And the war has never stopped. See, that's another thing. The war started when you established the system of white supremacy.
Yes, sir.
There's never been a truce declared.
Okay.
Not to say anything about peace being declared.
Yes, sir.
There's never even been a truce declared.
Yes, sir.
So, see, in other words, the white supremacists have won the war against non-white people so far. See, but the war isn't over as long as people are battling. And all these little, what you call World War II, World War I.
And you were in World War II.
All the other little wars and whatnot, Spanish-American War and all like that. These are just battles that are taking place within a war. See, battles take place all the time. Battles, I mean, just a couple of people fighting on the street. That's a battle.
Yes.
All right? Rodney King getting beat. That's a battle.
Yes.
That's a part of the war.
Yes.
But the real war is the war of the white supremacists against the non-white people of the entire planet.
Okay. Now, you were in...
That doesn't include all white people. Now.
Right.
I want to emphasize that. But those white people who are the smartest and most powerful, that's the logic of it. If the smartest and most powerful white people on the planet did not believe in white supremacy, then white supremacy wouldn't exist.
Mm-hmm.
Because you got to be smart and powerful to practice something that powerful.
Okay.
All right. You got to be smart, and you got to be smart first, and being smart will get you that kind of power.
Okay.
So if the white people who don't believe in white supremacy were smarter than those who do, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Okay.
Because white supremacy wouldn't exist.